So what do I consider the most promising? Interestingly enough, this is something that was just presented at a conference a month ago, and I do think this is the most promising of the minimally invasive glaucoma surgeries. And it's FDA approved, and it's essentially canaloplasty, but with a really elegant twist. Whereas canaloplasty, in the traditional method that it's been performed using Stegman's approach, requires making an external incision, a flap, and is a very long, tedious surgery. And one of the reasons why it's not taken off, even though it works as well as it does, it's not taken off because it just takes too long to do, right? AB Interno Canaloplasty, right, or minimally invasive canaloplasty surgery, does all of the things that canaloplasty does, with the exception of leaving the proline suture in the canal. So you get trabecular meshwork treated, because an opening is created with AB Interno. Schlemm's canal is dilated. Collector channel systems are also reopened. You get better aqueous outflow. And for those who are worried about leaving things in the eye, even if it's just a proline suture, and I do have patients who don't want the proline suture, I'll say, I think it works better if you stitch it open. They say, I don't want it in the eye. I want nothing in the eye. This is going to be a really great option. So this is Mark Gallardo actually developed this technique. And let me show you this video. It's really elegant. So he's just completed cataract surgery. Injects some viscoelastic in the eye. Now, normally, canaloplasty now, we'd create an incision right here, open up the conjunctiva, start creating a flap. What he's going to do is he's just going to create an oblique incision at the limbus through the cornea into the anterior chamber. And you'll see why he makes it in this direction rather than our usual kind of tangential. So what he's going to do shortly is insert the catheter, place a gonio lens. Sorry, I could have probably sped this up a bit. I believe that this is actually a real-time video. I can't remember whether he said it was or not. So there's the catheter. It's the same catheter that we use for traditional canaloplasty. He places it through that small little incision, and he's going to place it up in the angle here. This here is where the catheter is actually going to enter the canal. So again, instead of cutting down and entering the canal from the external approach, you're going to see in this video in just a moment how he's going to get this catheter into the canal from the internal approach and actually dilate the entire canal from the inside. So being gonioscopic surgery, put a little viscoelastic. You have to tilt the head. There are a couple of little maneuvers that you have to perform. And yeah, I do believe that this is a real-time video. So what he's showing you there is that's just a pair of, I believe, a capsular rexus forceps or bent needle cystotome. So it's a piece of surgical equipment that every cataract surgeon out there has. Okay, so you don't need to buy special equipment for this. Okay, so unlike, say, trabeculotome or something, there's no expensive equipment to buy. You take that. He's going to create a tiny little, just creating a tiny little opening in the trabecular meshwork, and you see how immediately you get reflux. I mean, this is visual proof. Whenever you see these minimally invasive surgeries. And you see that to me is just proof that, yes, it is the trabecular meshwork that's the problem. So now he's taking some micro forceps and just threading that catheter through the canal. And he's going to thread it all the way around. And you can see, here it is. You're looking through the sclera at the blinking tip of the microcatheter as it's passing around Schlemm's canal. And not every surgeon has these micro forceps, but you know, they're $600 to $1,000. So I mean, it's not like you're paying $50,000 for an instrument to do something. So now he's got the tip right there, and what he's going to do at this point is he'll place, going to reorient so that he can see what he needs to at the microscope. He's going to place another instrument right here to act as a fulcrum. So this instrument will keep the catheter from ripping through the trabecular meshwork as he pulls it back out and dilates the canal. So there's the blinking red tip of the catheter. And it actually is, I think, pretty cool to see. This is real time, unedited. And see, this is really fast. It's something that any skilled cataract surgeon could do. It's not technically that challenging. If you can put an eye stent in, you can do this. But as I show you, you would expect a significantly better result, so at least from the early studies. So now he's just removing the catheter, and as he's doing so, his technician is slowly injecting viscoelastic to dilate that canal and reopen the collector channel system. And that's it. He's done. So. And that's pretty much it in terms of what there is to see on that video. So how well does it work? Well, these are Dr. Gallardo's results here. And again, this procedure is something that's just been developed as an enhancement of canaloplasty. Canaloplasty has been available for a number of years. We have long-term results with the AB externo canaloplasty. They look really good, at least 3 years out. The AB interno canaloplasty actually looks really good early on. And so again, he's only been doing this for about 6 months, so he's only got a few patients out 6 months. But he's got a total of 70 patients here. They started out with pressure around 20 on over two medications. And you can see at 1 month, around 14 millimeters of mercury on one half medication, so every other person had none versus one. 3 months out, maintained at 13 millimeters of mercury, and 6 months, 12.3 millimeters of mercury. And so the 3 and the 6 month points are really important points, because most glaucoma surgeries, there's still some healing going on for the first 3 months. So I generally tell my patients, we don't really know whether your surgery was a success or failure until we're 3 months out. Once you get 3 months out, we can feel pretty good about it. And you can feel even better 6 months out. He's actually taken a look to see, well, of these patients, how many patients actually ended up with no medications at all, and what were their pressures? And you can see that a fair number of these patients, so 54 out of the 70 patients, ended up in his study so far with no medications. And you can see that, their pressures are doing very, very well in the 11 to 13 and change range. So it's still very, very early in terms of knowing will AB interno or minimally invasive canaloplasty work as well as the AB externo canaloplasty. But if we can get the results that are even near the AB externo canaloplasty with something that's minimally invasive, fast, doesn't require, $50,000 upfront investment from the surgery center, my sense is that this could really change the field of how we treat our patients with glaucoma, how early we take them to surgery, and, could even impact whether all these things that are not yet FDA approved are something that we even want to consider. If every one of these stents that aren't approved comes out, we know what they're all going to cost. Every one of these stents is going to be about $1,000, if not more, to implant. And so, these are things that fortunately, I'm not going to be the one that has to make these decisions in terms of what's covered and what's not. But it's nice to know that we have all of these potentials, some of which will be FDA approved, others not. Even the ones that are FDA approved are going to take years before they come across our shore. So in the meantime, I'm hoping that our patients can benefit from canaloplasty, and whether it's myself doing the surgery or somebody else makes little difference to me. I would just like to see this pick up, and I know that canaloplasty has not been as popular among surgeons simply because of the time constraints and how technically challenging it is. So this to me is just incredibly exciting because there's so many patients out there with open angle glaucoma who could benefit from a minimally invasive, effective surgery that doesn't require a huge upfront investment by either the surgery center, the surgeon, or the patient, or the patient's insurance. And as of today, most insurances, including Medicare, do now cover canaloplasty, right? They don't specify whether it's ab externo or interno. That's not in the in the coding, as far as I understand. The only ones that we still have trouble with, and this will come as no surprise to anybody, is Blue Cross. But other than Blue Cross, patients who have other insurance, including Medicare, canaloplasty is covered. So anyway, I hope that you share some of my excitement for many of these glaucoma surgeries. I hope that the more exciting, more effective surgeries will become FDA approved. But in the meantime, I think it's important to recognize that there are things that we can offer to our patients that are not, right now, as of today, that are not as risky as trabeculectomy or glaucoma drainage devices. And I'll now open it up for questions. Oh, by the way, one thing before questions, sorry, is just about all of the devices that I mentioned tonight, I have more detailed references, including what the current studies that are available show in terms of how effective they are, on my website here, newglaucomatreatments.com. So if anybody does want to research a bit more, I've done what I can to summarize the currently available research. I haven't yet added the results from the latest conference, which was ARVO, but I'm working on that right now.